हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, गुड मॉर्निंग। आई एम प्रेम गुप्ता, योर इंग्लिश टीचर। डियर स्टूडेंट्स, इन द प्रीवियस क्लासेस वी वर डिस्कसिंग द लिटरेचर पोर्शन। टुडे वी विल डिस्कस द ग्रामर पोर्शन, चैप्टर नंबर 4, दैट इज नाउन, काइंड्स ऑफ नाउन। डियर स्टूडेंट्स, इन ग्रामर पोर्शन वी हैव ऑलरेडी रेड द सेंटेंस, काइंड्स ऑफ सेंटेंस and parts of a sentence, that is predicate and subject, subject and predicate. Dear student, that is chapter number 4, that is noun and kinds of noun. Dear students, in the previous classes, in class 4, 5, we have read what is noun, what is the meaning of noun, what is the definition of noun. Dear students, once again we will study about noun, what is noun. So first of all, I want to tell you that whatever we are seeing in this world, that has a name, and that name is known as noun. Okay, you can say the naming word. Okay, naming word is known as noun. Or you can say a name of anything, name of anything known as noun. But we generally give the definition of noun, that noun is the name of a person, place, animal, thing, feeling or ideas. Okay, so first of all, just open your notebook. We will write what is noun, definition of noun. Just put the heading noun. Okay students, just open the notebook and just put the chapter number 4 and the chapter name, the noun, kinds of nouns, and then after put the heading noun, what is noun. Okay, now we will discuss what is meaning of noun. Okay, so just write down what is noun. A noun is the name, a noun is the name of person, comma, animal, comma, place, comma, thing, comma, feeling or idea. Okay students, just see here, a noun is the name of a person, is the name of a person, animal, place, thing, feeling or ideas. Okay, or we can also say that noun is a naming word. In short, we can say noun is a naming word, the name of anything known as noun. Okay, suppose that this is marker, we keep this thing, it is a thing, and we keep the name of this thing, that is marker, that is board, it is a name, it is the name of a thing, it is the name of a thing, marker. So that is noun. Board is noun, my name is noun, your name is noun. Okay, it means if you have any name, it means that is noun. Okay, or you can say very in a very simple language, that name of anything is known as noun. Okay dear student, this is the definition of noun. A noun is the name of a person, animal, place, thing, feeling or ideas. Dear students, just from the next line you write down, insert we can say that, we can say that, we can say that a noun is the naming word. It is the name of anything. It is the name of anything. Okay, students, just see, just write down this. In short, we can see that a noun is a naming word, or it is the name of anything. Okay, students, I hope that you all have understood what is noun. So we will see the example. Just see the example. Just write down the example. As the definition says, what it says, the name of a person. So we will see here person. We will see here person. Suppose that there is the name of a person, Mahatma Gandhi. Mahatma Gandhi is the name of a person. Therefore, the name Mahatma Gandhi is a noun. Okay. Next, as we are saying that name of animal. So we can see here animal. A-N-I-M-A-L. Okay. Name of animal. There are so many animals. Okay. For example, we can also write elephant. E-L-E-P-H-A-N-T is the name of an animal. Therefore, that is noun. And the next thing, place. Place is written here. So we will also see the place. Suppose that you live in Mirzapur. So we will write here M-I-R-Z-A-P-U-R. Mirzapur is the name of a place. Therefore, the word Mirzapur is also a noun. Okay, next example is saying thing. We are saying thing. T-H-I-N-G. Thing. Suppose that we have a pen. So, pen is a thing. Pen is a noun. Okay, feeling or ideas. You can say feeling or ideas. Feeling. Suppose that that person is full of goodness. Goodness, can we touch? No. It is a kind of feeling. It is a kind of idea. So, we can write here goodness. Okay, students, just see here goodness. Honesty. Okay. Wisdom. These are what? These are the feeling or ideas. Therefore, that is noun. So, students, I hope that you all have understood the name of a person, animal, place, thing, feeling or ideas. That is known as noun. And in short, we can say noun is the name of anything. Okay, it is a naming word. Okay, students, just write down up to this. This is the meaning or definition of noun that you have already read in the previous classes. In the previous class, class 4, class 5, I think you have read in class 1 also. Class 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and now you are reading the same topic, noun, in class 6 also. Okay? But here you have to study in detail the kinds of noun. Okay? First you complete it, then after we will discuss the kinds of a noun. Okay, students? Just do it first. And I hope that you all have completed this definition of noun with example. Okay, I am going to erase it. Now we will discuss the kinds. Dear students, if you have any kind of problem, you can mention in the comments. Okay? Just put the heading kinds of noun. Kinds of noun. just put the heading kinds of noun. Kinds of noun. Dear students, in the previous classes you have already read there are so many kinds. Generally we have read 5 kinds: proper noun, common noun, collective noun, material noun and abstract noun. But here we will categorize these kinds of noun in the 2 categories, that is countable noun and uncountable noun. Dear students, therefore you make a diagram. I'm going to make a diagram. You will also make that diagram. Here in the mid of the page you will write the noun, okay? And there are 2 parts of a noun. I am going to tell you. First one is countable noun, count, countable, okay, countable noun. And the second I am going to tell you, that is uncountable noun. Uncountable noun. Okay students, just see here, there are 2 kinds of noun: countable noun and uncountable noun. Countable noun and uncountable noun. Dear students, first of all I want to tell you what is countable noun. The noun which can be counted. The noun which can be counted, that is known as countable noun. Okay, for example, men. Can we count the number of men? Yes, we can count it very easily. 1 people, 2 people, 3 people, we can count. Book, we can count how many books are there. Okay, and but what is uncountable noun? The noun which cannot be counted, that is known as uncountable noun. For example, some water. Can we count water? No, we cannot count water. Gold. Can we count gold? No, we cannot count gold. We can count the rings, number of rings, number of jewelry, but we cannot count what? Gold. Okay. Can we count honesty? No, we cannot count honesty. Can we count goodness? No, we cannot count goodness. So that is uncountable noun. Okay students, so you keep in your mind that the noun which can be counted, that is known as countable noun. For example, man, book, table, etc. And uncountable noun, the noun which cannot be counted, that is known as uncountable noun. Okay, for example, water, oil, milk, honesty, etc. Okay, dear students, these 2 kinds of noun, countable noun and uncountable noun, can be categorized the other kinds, proper, common, material, collective and abstract noun, can be divided in 2 parts, countable and uncountable noun. So just make this diagram. Here we can count in the category of countable noun. Dear students, in the category of countable noun, we can keep proper noun. Just students, write down proper noun. Second, common noun. And third, collective noun. Collective noun. Okay. In the category of uncountable noun, we can keep 2 nouns only, that is material noun and 1 more, that is abstract noun. Okay, students, just see here. There are two kinds of noun, countable noun and uncountable noun. In the category of countable noun, we can keep proper noun, common noun, collective noun that we can count, and we cannot count material noun and abstract noun. Therefore, these two kinds of noun are also known as uncountable noun. Okay, students, just make this diagram. Okay, just see here. There are two kinds of noun mainly, that is countable noun and uncountable noun. In the category of countable noun, we can keep the proper, common and collective. In the category of uncountable noun, we can keep material and abstract noun. Okay, students, now we will discuss all these kinds of noun in detail. Okay, what is countable, what is uncountable, what is proper, what is common, what is collective, what is material and what is abstract noun. We will discuss all these kinds of noun in detail. Okay, so first of all, you make this diagram, and then after we will discuss countable and uncountable noun. Okay, students, so just make it first. And I hope that you all have made these diagrams, this diagram, kinds of noun. Okay, I am going to erase this. And I hope that you all have written these kinds. Okay, just see the next, put the next heading, that is countable noun. First of all, we will discuss what is countable noun. So here just put the heading countable noun. Countable noun. Dear students, I have already told you what is countable noun. The noun which can be counted, that is known as countable noun. The noun which can be counted, that is known as countable noun. So just write down first. The noun which can be counted. The noun which the nouns which can be counted the nouns which can be counted that is known as countable noun. Example we will see. You will see the example. Just write down example. What are they? Suppose that there is the name of a boy, Mohan. It denotes how many people? Only one, because this is the name of a person. So we can count this person, Mohan. So that is countable noun. Okay. Suppose that there is girl, G-I-R-L. Can we count the number of girls? Yes, that is countable noun. And etc. You can write etc. E-T-C. Okay, students, it is very simple that if we are able to count the thing, the people, then that is countable noun. If we are not able to count, that cannot be counted, that is known as uncountable noun. Therefore, just put the second heading, uncountable noun. Uncountable noun. Okay, students, just put the heading, uncountable noun. I hope that you all have understood what is countable noun. Now, just put the heading, uncountable noun. The noun which cannot be counted. Just write down here. The noun which cannot be the noun which cannot be counted. Okay, just write down. The noun which can be counted, that is known as countable. The noun which cannot be counted, that is known as uncountable noun. Okay? Such as we can also write, or example, we can write. Example, you write. It would be better. Okay? Example, we will see. For example, gold. Can we count gold? No. We cannot count gold. We can count the pieces of jewelry. We can count the rings. We can count the earrings. We can count the necklace. But we cannot count the gold. Okay, therefore that is uncountable noun. Water. Can we count? No, we cannot count. Okay, oil. Can we count? No, we cannot count. Okay, honesty. Can we count? No. Therefore, that is uncountable noun. Okay, students, I hope that you all have understood what is countable and what is uncountable. The noun which can be counted, that is known as countable, and the noun which cannot be counted, that is known as uncountable. Example, you have seen. Okay, Mohan, girls, etc. are countable nouns. Gold, water, oil, honesty, etc. are uncountable nouns. Okay, students, so just you write this, these kinds of noun. Now we will discuss, I have told you students, in the category of countable noun, we can keep proper, common and collective nouns. In the category of uncountable noun, we can keep material and abstract noun. So we will discuss these kinds of noun: proper noun, common noun, collective noun, material noun and abstract noun. Okay? So just put the heading proper noun. Okay, I am going to erase it. And you put the heading proper noun. Just put the heading proper noun. P-R-O-P-E-R, proper noun. Okay, students, just put the heading proper noun. Dear students, I want to tell you orally first what is proper noun, then you can understand. Dear students, proper noun is the name of a particular. Particular means special, specific. Okay? Particular means special, specific. Proper noun is the name of a particular person, particular person, particular place, particular animal, particular things. Okay? Where there is name of particular. You can say it is the name of a particular living thing or non-living thing. Okay? So that is known as proper noun. For example, we can see here, we are talking about APJ Abdul Kalam. APJ Abdul Kalam. It is the name of a particular person. It is the name of a leader. So that is proper noun. Your name is also proper noun. Okay, my name is also proper noun, because that is specific, that is special. And where do you live? In Chunar. Chunar is the name of a particular city, particular place. Therefore, the word Chunar is also proper noun. When we are talking about a particular name of an animal, although there are so many animals, but when we talk about a particular animal, lion, so that is proper noun. Okay? So, the name of anything that is particular, that is special, that is specific, that is known as proper noun. Okay, students? So, just put the heading proper noun and we will write about the proper noun. What is proper noun? Just see here, just write down. What is proper noun? A proper noun is the name of a proper a proper noun is the name of particular person. Dear students, you have to use this word particular. Okay, proper noun is the name of a particular person, animal, place or thing. Okay, just see here. What is the meaning of proper noun? Proper noun is the name of a particular person, animal, place or thing. That is known as proper noun. Okay? Just see the example. We will see the example of proper noun. Okay, just see. Suppose that we are talking about the particular person. Here, particular person. What would be the particular person? As I have told you, APJ Abdul Kalam is the name of a particular person. So that is proper noun. Your name. Suppose that your name is Ayushman. AUSHMAN. The name Ayushman is also a particular name. Therefore, that is proper noun. Here, APJ Abdul Kalam is the name of a particular person. Therefore, that is also known as proper noun. Okay? So, here, particular person. We have given the example of particular person. Now, we can see here, particular animal. We will see the example of particular animal. Just see here, particular animal. Although there are so many animals in this world, okay, but when we talk about the particular animal, lion, that is known as proper noun. Okay, suppose that we are talking about dog. It is the name of a particular animal, that is also proper noun. Okay, if we are talking about a particular animal, tiger, that is also what? Proper noun. Okay, when we talk about a particular thing, particular person, particular animal, that is known as proper noun. Here, next example we will see, place, particular place. Just see here, particular place. What would be the particular place? Suppose that we are talking about Delhi. Delhi is the name of a particular place, particular city. So that is proper noun. We are talking about Varanasi. Varanasi also is the name of a particular city. So that is also proper noun. Okay, students, now we will discuss particular thing. Okay, now we will see particular thing. Particular thing. In the category of particular thing, there are so many things. Okay, suppose that we have particular thing, book. There are so many books in this world. But when we talk about a particular book, okay, suppose that Ramayana. Suppose that we are talking about the particular book, that is Ramayana. That is known as what? That is particular name of a book, that therefore that is proper noun. Ramayana. We are talking about particular planet. Although there are 8 planets, when we talk about a particular planet, that is known as, suppose that we are talking about Earth, E-A-R-T-H. That is also known as what? Particular things, Earth. But remove it, it may be place, Earth. Here, when we talk about a particular pen, suppose that fountain pen. F-O-U-N-T-A-I-N, fountain pen. Okay, that is also the name. There are so many pens, but when we talk about a particular pen, that would be the proper name. Okay, students, I hope that you all have understood what is proper noun. Proper noun is the name of a particular person, particular animal, particular place, and particular things. Okay, students, I hope that you all have understood whatever I have taught today. Definition of noun, kinds of noun, and in the kinds of noun, we have discussed countable, uncountable, and proper noun. And whatever I have taught you, you revise it. In the next class, we will discuss the rest part of rest kinds of noun. Okay, that's all for today. Thank you.